Feel the Great Gang video out on time for once this week. Gonna be a good week.
Alright, it is a brand new day. Hello everybody and welcome to Tuesday, September the 21st, 2021. Shane Beamer had his weekly presser today. Named Luke Doty the starting quarterback for the Kentucky game, which is great. It's officially Luke Doty season. It's great, even though the depth chart earlier today said Zeb Nolan or Luke Doty, but Beamer said it's Doty as long as his foot doesn't flare up, which is great news. And no, you know, real updates to the injury report besides that Sherrod Green continued to pray for him. He's had his surgery. He's recovering. Beamer's hopeful he can be back by the end of November, but he's probably not going to play now down this season. But, and I'll talk about this season. Let's talk about next season, as the SEC has released the 2022 schedule. It starts at home against Georgia State on September the 3rd, and then September the 10th at Arkansas, September the 17th, home against Georgia, September the 24th against Charlotte at home, October 1st against SC State at home, October the 8th at Kentucky, and then we get the bye week on the 15th, and then October 23rd at versus A&M at home, and October 29th versus Missouri, two SEC games right in a row at home, and then two right in a row on the road, at Vanderbilt on November the 5th, at Florida on November the 12th, versus Tennessee at home on November 19th, and at Clemson on November 26th. So yeah, takeaways. Weird playing Tennessee that late in the season. I'm not going to go to State or Upper State next season because you got home against A&M and home against Missouri right on those weekends. Hey, I actually get to go to 5A State, though. I get to go to 5A State because at Vanderbilt is that first Saturday in November. So look at that. That's great. When we welcome Georgia State home, when we welcome Georgia State to Willy B to start the season, Sean Elliott will be coming back to Columbia, served on some of the latter Steve Spurrier staffs and served as interim head coach after he resigned. So it'll be nice to see him back on the sidelines again. At Arkansas, going to be a fun one. Year three of Sam Pittman versus year two of Shane Beamer, two downtrodden programs revitalizing themselves with new cultures. And then, you know, get the non-conference, you got to beat Georgia State, Charlotte, and SC State. You know, go 3-1 in your non-conference at least. And then we need to get to the point, you know, by 2022, home against Missouri and home against Tennessee should be considered dubs, honestly. That's what it's going to take time for Beamer, I understand that, but, and I'm not, like, going to be like, oh, fire Beamer if we lose to Tennessee at home or lose to Missouri at home. But we need to get to that point. But yeah, good schedule. Good schedule. All right, it is a brand new day. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Wednesday, September the 22nd, 2021. Since rehearsal got canceled and it's another rainy day, and yesterday I talked about the 2022 football schedule, let's talk about the 2021 schedule for women basketball and baseball, or at least the conference schedule for baseball. Those dropped the past few days and last week. For women basketball in the non-conference, November 9th at NC State, November 12th versus South Dakota in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. November 17th, home opener versus Clemson. I don't think there's much of a better game you got. November 20th versus Buffalo in the Bahamas. And then November 21st, either versus Oregon or Oklahoma in the Bahamas in some sort of tournament. I don't remember what the name of it. There's a lot of them. Playing November 2nd in the Bahamas. So I think still that same tournament. Don't know who we're playing. November 26th, home against Elon. November 29th, home against NC State A&T. December the 3rd, home against Kansas State. December 12th, home against Maryland. December 15th, at Duke. December 21st, home against Stanford. And then we get our conference schedule. December 30th, at Missouri. January the 2nd, versus Ole Miss. January the 6th, at LSU. January the 9th, versus Kentucky. The 13th, versus A&M. The 16th at Arkansas, the 24th versus Vanderbilt, and then January 27th, you have the annual game against UConn. And then January the 30th at Florida, February the 3rd versus Alabama, February the 6th versus Mississippi State, February the 10th at Kentucky, February the 13th at Georgia, February 17th versus Auburn, February the 20th versus Tennessee, February the 24th at A&M, and then February the 27th at Ole Miss. So that's the schedule. It's great seeing, you know, teams like Maryland, Stanford, UConn on there. Of course, UConn we play every year in our rivalry. We have Wagino in them. Finally got our first win back in 2020, right before everything shut down. It was great being at that game with 18,000 screaming Gamecock fans in CLA. And I'm sure I'm going to be at probably the Maryland, Stanford, and UConn games. Of course, you know, Maryland, everyone was thinking we were going to play Maryland in the SEC tournament, in the NCAA tournament this past season, and I was a little worried about them because they had a really good offense, like 90, 100 points a game. And I felt like we struggled at times putting points up on the board this past season. But then Texas beat them. So I was like, okay, feel confident about beating Texas, especially since it's Vic Schaefer. We owned him when he was at Mississippi State, and we shut him at like 60-ish, 70-ish, something, to 38, I think. I don't remember. But we held him scoreless in the fourth quarter, and that was great. And then versus Stanford, I tell you, we freaking beat Stanford. I don't care what the scoreboard said, what, a 62-61 final or something like that. I don't care what the scoreboard says. We beat Stanford. The refs called a horrendous game with a kickball and a shove right against us. Still hate that game. Just seeing that at whatever weekend it was and being super depressed afterwards. But yeah. And then freaking going on to win the whole title by 1 point. It's nuts. We would have dominated Arizona in the title game, but we get the chance at CLA to destroy Stanford, and I'm sure we will. Return literally everybody from the team, plus add like a ton more talent already. And then of course versus UConn, that's gonna be a good game. We were nearly close to beating them in 2021 in their place. If it weren't for, you know, like a freaking trick shot or a lucky shot that went right off the rim, up like 6 feet in the air, and right back in. That was a game. But yeah. And then in conference play, we'll get our revenge on Texas A&M for, you know, beating us and stealing the regular season crown from us. We'll beat Tennessee, even though we beat them in the tournament and destroyed them. And I guess going back to the non-conference, you know, get a chance to hopefully redeem ourselves against NC State for giving us that first loss last season. But yeah, women's basketball, going undefeated. Like, honestly, there's a real decent shot at going undefeated with the team we got. But making a case for the number one overall seed in the tournament. And then at that point, just make a run. And I feel confident in the team to make a run. But we'll see. We don't have to worry about Dawn Squad until March. And until, like, you know, close to the end of March, anyway. But yep, SEC slate released for Gamecock baseball last week, in which it's at Tennessee, March 18th through the 20th, versus Vanderbilt, March 25th to 27th, at Missouri, April 1st through 3rd, versus Georgia, April 8th through 10th, versus Ole Miss, April 14th through 16th, at Auburn, April 22nd through 24th, versus Alabama, April 29th to May 1st, at A&M, May 6th to the 8th, versus Kentucky, May 13th to 15th, and at Florida, May 19th to the 21st. First of all, I know I'm going to try to get to more of these games, because I did not go to... If this was last year's schedule, I would only go to the Kentucky series. But yeah, because I did not go to games at all throughout the semester and waited till the end for some dumb reason, but... I mean, it's very great that we pulled Auburn, Alabama, and A&M, and Ole Miss from the West. Very nice to have Bama, Auburn, and A&M instead of LSU, Mississippi State, and Arkansas. But yeah, this could be a 20-plus win ball club. Could be. There's question marks on the roster from what we lost in, you know, Wes Clark and Thomas Farr and all the guys we lost that I talked about over the summer. But, you know, going to be rough going to Tennessee to start SEC play and ending SEC play at Florida. But you get Vanderbilt at home. You get Ole Miss at home. That's great. I mean, like, Tennessee, Vanderbilt, Ole Miss, and Florida, the only series that really scare me that much. I mean, the SEC, anybody can beat anybody. It's the toughest baseball conference. Tougher conference than anything, especially once Oklahoma and Texas join. Yeah, speaking of Texas joining, oof. We're also playing Texas in a series this upcoming season at Founders, so that's going to be a great series. Going to be great seeing them on the schedule more often, but yeah, good. I mean, the expectation is to be hosting another regional and making it out of it and maybe hosting a super, but at least host another regional and win it, but good. We got a good slate of women basketball and, you know, baseball series upcoming for the year.
All right, it is a brand new day. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Thursday, September the 23rd. Gonna be a busy weekend. Going back home to the Woodruff game tomorrow. Gonna be fixing up our drumline mascot. Get him a new voice box from Gilstrap. Squirt the Dolphin. And SEC Nation are coming to rehearsal tomorrow to actually record some footage. That's gonna be pretty cool. That if I can get back on campus early enough Saturday morning, hopefully be making it out to the Horseshoe for SEC Nation. That's gonna be pretty cool, but you know, two football games. Woodruff playing Greer tomorrow night. Hopefully, you know, with Corey Scott back at, you know, at quarterback, now established as the starter, we can get the dub. But you know, it's gonna be nice to see Woodruff get a halftime performance in before they got their first competition at Byrnes Saturday, and then, you know, we got Kentucky coming in Saturday, and hopefully, you know, we can get a big statement win for Shane Beamer's first year. Let's get it. It is a brand new day. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Friday, September the 24th, 2021. As you can tell, I'm out here in the Horseshoe. The Paul Feinbaum show is going on right now. And, you know, just neat that, you know, they're in Columbia right now. Some going to be some nice exposure for, you know, the football program under Shane Beamer. And Beamer is going to be on the show. They got 4:15, I think, Daunt Daly is. And later in the day, Frank Martin is, but doesn't matter to me. I gotta go to rehearsal. So, yeah. You know, maybe I can find a clip or two, but, you know. Gonna just have some rehearsal today. As I mentioned, SEC Nation gonna be videoing some of it. But, yep, rehearsal, and then go back home for Woodruff. Got a good, you know, halftime performance to go catch, hopefully. But, yeah, let's get it. Back. 3:30 left in a running clock in the second quarter. Woodruff down 12-14. But the great thing is I made it. Let's go.
Okay, offense one.
Quickly.
Hey,
everybody?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
All right.
Number 17, Crosby, on the quarterback.
Six, five, six.
It would be cool if you would watch and play when it's time. Thank you.
Five, six.
All right, so it's later. Woodruff lost to Greer, 35-19. It sucks. We're now 1-3. After winning our first game, we lost to the last three. I really don't have anything I can really say about it. I don't know. You can barely pay attention to it because I was just frantically trying to drive here for halftime. I did halftime. And then, you know, just hang out with my friends who I haven't seen in a while. And, you know, hang out with Gilstrap. But yes, operation on squirt, as I mentioned yesterday, didn't work out. So I have squirt right here. He cannot speak because we could not get the other dolphin apart. And we had completely messed him up. And we weren't going to, me and Gilstrap would be banned from the Carolina Band drum line if we met up squirt. So we were not going to do that. But he found a lover, Squirtina. He found something greater. So yeah, that's nice. But the big day for tomorrow across South Carolina, Woodruff is going to the Byrnes competition, in which they're actually going to be, I know for a fact they're going to be going up against Kelly Powell's group from West Oak, former USC drum major from last season, so good luck to her, but not too much luck, because Woodruff needs to take home, apparently, actually never mind, need to take home the Silver Division title. So, yep, good luck to them. And tomorrow, you know, the Kentucky game. SEC Nation in the morning. I'm going to be trying to leave here probably super early. But yeah, let's get it. All right, it is a brand new day. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Saturday, September the 25th. Back on campus here at USC from the football game back home yesterday. Got squirt. I still wish we could have replaced that, but I mean, when me and Gilstrap couldn't live to return to the CBDL with messing him up, so we didn't bother. But, yep, time to head to the horseshoe for SEC Nation before call time. And, you know, the game day really begins. But, yeah, let's get it.
T-Bone!
I saw the Statue of Liberty this week for another shoot I was doing, yeah. And you just stand there in awe at its majesty. I feel the same, like, oh. The majesty of the Heisman Trophy.
Well,
and it's yours, man.
I tell you what, a lot of people made me look good.
Yeah.
A lot of people made me look good, and that's what it's about. Teamwork. Teamwork. That's what it's about.
Why is it important to you to share it with so many people?
Because that's what it's for. It's for Carolina. Yeah. Carolina. Oh, yeah.
Give it up for the band, y'all. Wow. Listen, everybody's out here. We got the flag bearers singing.
So good, so good, so good.
Come on.
You guys are awesome, by the way.
Shout out to this guy right here. This guy's a man right here. That's a tight shit. I got some giveaways. What's up, big dog? If anybody banks with Regis, the official bank of the SEC, I want to see a card. pull a card out, and I got a patch for you. My man, I like this. You know what? Biggest reason fans, you get a bag.
Patrick.
Wait a minute. Whoa!
Patrick.
It still has a sticker on it. That means it's new. It's a brand new account. Wait, you got three cards in there. This guy's Mr. Region.
Yeah, Patrick!
So good!
Hey, you guys know how to party over here. Is that true? Oh my goodness. Alright, who wants a t-shirt? I still got a few more I want to give out.
I'm very real and very genuine. I think they see that this is not some act. This is where I want to be. There's nowhere else in the world that I want to coach. I want to coach here for the rest of my career, and I've seen what we've been able to do here in the past in winning big football games and competing for SEC championships. We got a lot of recruits that are here today. We got a lot of recruits that I see in the crowd that can help us go win championships here really, really soon. But that's the biggest thing, is just be yourself, be real, be consistent. And we got some great, great, great young men in our program that I just love coaching and being around each and every day, and that's what it's about.
And I am perplexed because I want to be popular, something I've never been in my life.
Okay, you want to be popular.
But I also want to be real. So let me have that Kentucky flag.
Oh, man.
Uh-oh.
And you know what I think? I've been here for 24 hours. I'm on the shade train!
All right, it's Larry now. Just got back from SEC Nation a little while ago. It was great out there. Great atmosphere, great crowd, and it's just great seeing the publicity and coverage that this program is getting under Beamer. And, you know, just ready to see what heights he's going to take this program to. And today could be a great first step if, you know, if we can pull off this, I guess, according to Vegas, an upset, even though it's not really that much of an upset. Just be a nice statement window, considering we've lost, what, 6 out of 7? The last time, but the last time the Cats came to Willy B, that we won. That's great. And Paul Feinbaum picking us to win, just chucking blue rally towels into the crowd. You love to see it, but let's go get it. Hell yeah. Feel good to be back in the indoor. Let's get at it now. We got 6, 5-ish hours. I don't know. Let's go.
Then more excitement about South Carolina football than there is right now. And I'm with them.
Thank you.
Byrnes. Let's welcome tonight's celebrity starter who most recently led Team USA to a gold medal at the 2020 Olympics, your Gamecock women's basketball head coach, Dawn Staley.
Hey, Gamecock fans, get up, stand up, stay up, we the best. You know the assignment, this side is Game, this side is Cox.
It is a brand new day. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Sunday, September the 26th, 2021. Just here trying to recover emotionally as the Gamecocks fall to Kentucky 16-10 at home. Well, offense continues to struggle, especially, you know, offensive line. You can't open up the running game worth of crap, and we have, you know, like four great SEC running backs, and they, you know, only got 58 rushing yards. What else is there to say? Like, you know, and they've been very opportunistic this whole season, especially yesterday. They had three drives starting in Kentucky territory, had, you know, a plus three turnover margin, two fumbles within, you know, Kentucky territory pretty much in the end of the game. But, you know, only put 10 points up. And if we, you know, we hold an SEC team to 16 points, you know, we should win. We should win, period. But yeah, defense continued to do great things. Defense, you know, a lot better than we probably gave them credit for in the preseason. And then special teams, you know, Parker White kicked a 54-yard field goal at the end, which is a new career long for him. And he now sits 44 points away from Elliott Fry's record for all-time points, which, great for him. But yeah, it was great to be out there yesterday. It was a great atmosphere. It was great, you know, to see a sellout, see the student section staying there. Yeah, just doing a great job selling the recruits in the building of what Gamecock football could be. But yeah, it was great to see family there. It was great. It was family weekend. My mother went. Some family friends went. I met up with C. Philly again at SEC Nation. I even met Marco, the guy who made the Sandstorm remix, so that was pretty cool. Yeah, other news, Clemson lost, which was great. That partially carried the day yesterday, because it was like 25 minutes in. That they said on the scoreboard, Clemson lost to NC State 27-21. They've already got two losses, and it's not even October yet, and they're basically eliminated from college football playoff contention, which is great. Good job, Clemson. Suck to suck. But they've got bigger problems than not making the playoff at this point. They've got bigger problems. So, yep. But enough about college football. Woodruff won first place in their class at the Byrnes competition yesterday. They won best percussion, best music, and first place in class 4 with 72.41 points. Chedney got second and Broom got third. And then, you know, Greer won the silver division. Didn't even go to the dang football game, of course. And then I wanted to give a shout out to Kelly Powell. I mentioned, you know, former USC drum major and current director at West Oak, because her group got first place in class 2 along with Beth Percussion, so good job to them. And D Sims, former Woodruff percussion instructor, you know, he's now working with York. He got his group, they got first place in class 7 with best music and best guard and gold division champs. So good job to the both of them.